أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming. وبارك الله فيكم and ask Allah make it in our balance in front of Allah عز وجل in dunya and آخرة. In Ayat al-Kursi, as I already read in the prayer, the last two names of it, Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. هو, Allah Azza wa Jal, الْعَلِيُّ, the most high, الْعَظِيمُ, the most great. And my topic, inshallah, will go about عَظَمَةُ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. الْعَظَمَةُ, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned about His greatness. What we should know about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which should tell us about some of the greatness of Allah. And from the beginning, doesn't matter how much I describe, it will not be enough to describe the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we ask Allah by His great name to give tawfiq for at least some of it inshaAllah. In Surah Taha, Surah number 20, Ayah number 14, Allah Azza wa Jalla talking about Himself, saying, إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِيمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهِ. Allah talking about Himself, saying, I am Allah. Which this is for the, we say for the non-Muslim, especially for the Christian, where is Jesus said, Innani an Allah? There is no. Allah talking about Himself, and very clear and direct, I am Allah. La ilaha illa ana. None has the right to be worshipped except Him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah said, Fa'budni, worship me alone. Wa aqim as-salata li-dhikri, perform as-salah for the remembrance of Allah. And Allah loves al-Jalala, the name of Allah, mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim at the beginning of every surah, 2,810 times. Allah, the name of Allah, mentioned inside the Quran al-Kareem with the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, because Bismillah started with Allah, Bism Allah, 2,810 times. If you take out Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it will be 2,697. In Surah Al-Shura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about Himself. Surah number 42, ayah number 11, Allah said, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He is the all-hearer, the all-seer. And where is Him over His throne? Surah Taha, ayah number 5, Surah number 20, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Ar-Rahman ala al-Arsh istawa. Ar-Rahman rose over al-Arsh, rose over the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this ayah itself, or a part of ayah, mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem 6 different times. I already explained that before. In Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 255, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say at the end of ayat al-Kursi, وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah never feel fatigue. Allah does not get tired. Because this is in other religion, they say Allah get tired for that He take rest. Allah doesn't get tired. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about Himself, I never get tired. In guarding and preserving the heaven and the earth. And he is the most high, Al-Ali, the most great, Al-Azim. In Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, Ayah number 129, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching us, عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتْ Depend upon Allah. Trust Allah only. How you know that in a hardship you face? Suppose especially about that calamity, the money. If you lose the money, still your trust in Allah, or you will be worried and fear and disturbed and don't know what to do. If you trust Allah, doesn't matter, there is money, there is no money, your trust depends on Allah. But if your trust in money, as in when you lose it, even you think that you trust Allah and you depend upon Allah, then when you lose the money, you feel many bad feelings, then there is something wrong. You have to correct your creed. You have to correct your aqidah. For that Allah teaching us, عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتْ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ And he is the Lord of the great throne. He is the greatest and he is the Lord of the great throne. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah number 23, Ayah number 86, قُلْ مَنْ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ السَّبْعِ وَرَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ قُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ Say to them, who is the Lord of the seven heaven? Who is the Lord of the sky? Who created? Nobody can claim that created except Allah Azza wa Jal. And he is the Lord of the great throne. And when you ask them, who is the Lord of that and who is the one creator of the heaven and the earth, they will say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Surah Al-Haqqah, Surah number 69, Ayah number 33, Allah Azza wa Jal will say to the one who have his book of record, with his left hand, who ask Allah save us from having our book of record with the left hand. Say Ameen. Ask Allah save us, Ameen. Then one of the reasons he getting his own book of record with the left hand, Surah Al-Haqqah, Ayah number 33, إِنَّهُ كَانَ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ Verily, he used not to believe in Allah Al-Azim, the most great. For that part of your iman and part of your getting your own book of record, with the right hand to believe in Allah and azamat of Allah, and to believe in the greatness of Allah. And your behavior will depend upon how much you believe in the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Hajj, Allah mentioned about himself, Al-Haq, Al-Ali, Al-Kabir. Al-Haq, the truth. Al-Ali, the most high. Al-Kabir, the most great. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقَّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرِ ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ Allah is the truth. And whatever they call beside Allah is a false. Not true. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ Allah Azza wa Jal is Al-Ali, the most high, Al-Kabir, the most great. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِي عَلِمَ مَا كَانَ وَمَا يَكُونُ وَمَا لَمْ يَكُنْ لَوْ كَانَ كَيْفَ يَكُونُ وَمَتَى يَكُونُ وَأَيْنَ يَكُونُ The greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows everything. He knows whatever will be happen and whatever already happen. Nothing is hidden from Allah. And whatever does not happen, if it happen, how it will be and where it will be and which place. As we know, if there is a leaf of a tree going down, Allah knows if it goes down to a dry area or it goes down to a wet area. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing hidden from Allah. Allah teaching us about His greatness in Surah Yunus. Ayah number 61, Surah number 10. وَمَا يَعْزُبُ عَنْ رَبِّكَ مِنْ مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَلَا أَصْغَرُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْبَرُ There is nothing hidden of Allah, even a weight of an atom. In the heavens or in the earth. في الأرض, in the earth or in the heaven. Not less than this, not great. Not less and not bigger. Because an atom now, this is what we know. Suppose we come to discover something is less. Allah say, وَلَا أَصْغَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ Nothing less than the weight of an atom. مثقال الزرة, not bigger than it, hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowledge of Allah is so wide. Our knowledge is limited. Limit of the source you have, limit of the time, limit of the field. Some in this field cannot know nothing about that field. Some in that field doesn't know nothing about the other field. Knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal have no any kind of limit. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah 7, Surah 34, Ayah number 2, Allah Azza wa Jal said, يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا وَمَا يَنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ الْغَفُورُ. He knows whatever goes in the earth, and he knows whatever come out of it. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever come down of the sky. He knows whatever goes up to the sky. And he is the most merciful, the most forgiver, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And out of his greatness, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal write upon himself and prescribed upon himself rahmah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-An'am, Surah number 6, Ayah number 12, كتب على نفسه الرحمة. He wrote upon himself الرحمة. To be merciful to everything. Surah Al-A'raf, describe more. Out of the greatness of Allah. Ayah number 156, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء فسأكتبها للذين يتقون ويؤتون الزكاة والذين هم بآياتنا يؤمنون. Allah Azza wa Jal say, my rahmah cover everything. And actually, the rahmah of Allah send it down, coming the hadith later, inshallah, to the earth, is 1 out of 100. And he kept with him 99. Out of this one, all creation be merciful to each other, including the animal does not step upon its own baby out of that mercy. Allah say, my rahmah cover everything. وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. He said, I will write my rahmah to those who yattaqoon, have taqwa, they fear Allah. They know who is he. They know about the greatness of Allah. And they give his zakah, and those who believe in the ayat of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal saying, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل. Those who follow also رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, رحمتي, about Allah said, رحمتي سبقت وفي رواية غلبت غضبي. My rahmah, Allah عز وجل saying, حديث القدسي, my rahmah overcome my غضب, my anger. Mercy of Allah proceed and more and wide and cover everything, and it covers even the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means he be more merciful than more being angry. There is hadith of Qudsi. Allah Azza wa Jal say, Al-Azamatu Rida'i Izari Wal-Kibriya'u Rida'i Faman Naza'ani Wahidan Minhuma Qasamtuhu Wala Ubali. The greatness is my cloth, and proudness is my garment. And whoever fight me against any one of them, I will break him. But start with al-azama, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One part of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he is al-ghaffar. He is the most merciful and he is the most forgiver. Do as much as mistake you want, but go back to Allah and ask him to forgive. And do real tawbah. Even you meet Allah with the whole land, the hadith is coming, whole land full of mistakes, and you ask Allah really with his rahmah to forgive you, he will forgive you. You come to meet Allah with the whole earth full of your mistake, but with one condition, to meet him we avoid one mistake, because the hadith itself is saying that ثُمَّ لَقِيَ اللَّهَ لَا يُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا لَأَتَاهُ بِقِرَابِهَا مَغْفِرًا. And he meet Allah, does not have any kind of shirk, any kind of shirk. And this is the most important thing for the Muslim, to know what is shirk. It's not only a word, it is so huge topic. If you avoid that, any other sin, even full of the earth of it, Allah will meet you with full of the earth of forgiveness. Full of the earth rahmah for you. And still, with even all of these big mistakes, you will go to Jannah by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He is a Razzaq. Not only that, if the whole human being, from the first one till the last one, and the whole jinn, everyone ask whatever he wants, and Allah Azza wa Jalla give it to them, it will never ever reduce the kingdom of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and the rizq Allah have, and the treasures Allah have, not even equal to the needle, if you put it in an ocean. What will it take? Nothing. This is from the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is owner of all treasures. He is the owner of all and everything. For that, relate yourself to Him. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. If you ask, ask Allah alone. The great. العظيم. وَإِذَا استعنت. If you seek help from Him. If you depend upon the people, sometimes, they will play with your mind. Sometimes they will help, sometimes not. But if you depend upon Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, will never disgrace you. But if you really know how to depend upon Him, how to ask Him, how to seek help from Him, if He really is in your heart, really He is in your mind, you remember Him always. And you will know that at the time of hardship, as I start one topic. You are in a hardship, and really, suppose you are in an accident. This is a time, if you remember Allah right away, means Allah is in your heart, really. Allah is with you, and Allah is in your mind. Really, you remember Allah Azza wa Jalla. But if in a time of accident, you remember everything except Allah, then astaghfirullah, ask Allah, save us from that. This is just as example. Look to yourself when you feel down. Feel down, suppose there is anything, raining or whatever it is, and you come or walking upon snow, then all of a sudden, beep, you feel down. What will you say at that time? Oh Allah, or many other things. Some people, they will remember everything except Allah Azza wa Jalla. But some people, the mu'min, they will remember Allah at that time. And how to get that? How to get to that high level? Make Allah in your mind all the time. Remember Him all the time. Read the Quran all the time. Be connected to Him all the time. Sacrifice the dunya for Allah. But do not sacrifice whatever for Allah for the dunya. Because one of two, either you sacrifice the dunya for your deen, or you sacrifice your deen for your dunya. At the same time, will you get more than what Allah write to you in dunya? Wallah, you will never get anything except whatever Allah write exactly. No more and no less. For that, be with Allah. Allah will give whatever already written. Take the reason. I'm not saying neglect dunya completely. Allah Azza wa Jalla in Quran al-Kareem said, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Do not forget your portion from the dunya. But do not make it your main target. Do not make yourself so busy with it day and night and you forget about Allah Azza wa Jalla. How you calculate that so easy? Ask yourself before you've been asked. How many hours, how many minutes for Allah? How many hours, how many minutes for the dunya? If it is for the dunya 10 hours a day and for Allah 10 minutes, is this good? Is it good? Answer me please. Is it good? No. No. At all. What will you say to Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Day of Judgment? Are somebody doing that? Really, he is related to Allah Azza wa Jalla. He knows about the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jalla. He knows who Allah Azza wa Jalla. Believe me, no. Even he knows the name. He knows just the name. But does really he know him? Allah says in the Quran Kareem about some people. We ask Allah to save us from being like them. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They do not estimate Allah as it should be given to him. They do not know Allah. They do not respect Allah. They do not know about the greatness of Allah. Even they think that they know. Does Allah watch you all the time or not? Yes. Are you, يعني, can you or can you hide yourself while you're doing mistake from Allah? You cannot. If you know that Allah is watching you, and this is really in your mind, you will never ever go near to any mistake. But if it is sometimes, especially if you are alone, in all kind of wrong and haram, then do not blame except your own self. At least the time you are spending in that, you can spend in something good. Praying to rak'ah, reading the Quran. Know Allah Azza wa Jalla. Know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the whole human being and jinn ask Allah and Allah gives them whatever they want, it will never reduce the kingdom of Allah and will never ever reduce the rizq Allah have and the treasures Allah have. Nothing. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving that, and Allah himself giving that example. Exactly as a needle, the one you sew your clothes with it. You put it in an ocean, what will it take from the whole ocean? Nothing. It's the same. After Allah give everybody whatever you want. Allah is al-Alim, the most knowledgeable, unlimited. Our knowledge, limited. Al-Alim, not limited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أحاط بكل شيء علما. His knowledge cover everything. ماض وآت. In past and in future. متحرك وساكن. Moving or not. كبير وصغير. Knowledge of Allah cover big things and small things. Even small, less than the weight of an atom. عالم بعلمه عدد أنفاس خلقه. Not only the number of the creation, which the human being knows it now. Allah knows even how many breathing you will have. And how many breathing as a total for the whole human being. 7 billion now. How many breathe for everyone? Knowledge of Allah has that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows about their moving. Allah knows about their sitting. Allah knows about your good deeds. Allah knows whatever in your heart. Knowledge of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, unlimited. For our knowledge, impossible. You will be deceived by the saying of the people. Allah cannot. Impossible. Allah said in the Quran Kareem, يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. He knows whatever in your heart. عليكم السلام. Allah knows how much rizq you will get, from where you will get, when you will die, how long you will live. Knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows before you do anything, are you one of the people of al-Jannah or not? And He does not force you for anything. Allah knows if you are people of al-Nar or not also. Does not force you. He show you the right, show you the wrong. Say you do this, do not do that. The halal and the haram, the right and the wrong. If you are really one of the people who love Allah Azza wa Jal, and who want to be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he want to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he want the Jannah, Allah will make it easy for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only whatever in the land, whatever in the sea. Nowadays, after millions of years, we come to discover some of the stuff in the sea few years ago. Allah knows that before it created. Knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have no limit. Not even a grain. Fill down in a dry area or in a wet area. What will come and when it will come. And how what will bring, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know any woman become pregnant or even losing her baby, except with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. This is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is beneficial. In Arabic, النَّافِعُ الضَّارِ. النَّافِعُ is the one who gives benefit. الضَّارِ is the one who harm. And is the one who remove your harm. Remove your problems. Is Allah only. Allah said in the Quran Kareem, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فلا كاشف له إلا هو وإن يمسسك بخير فهو على كل شيء قدير. الله سبحانه وتعالى say, if Allah touch you with any harm, with any little problem, Allah, if He love you, touching you with that, He want to remind you, go back to me. Nobody, Allah say, nobody can remove that from you, that harm from you, except Him alone. Nobody can remove that from you except Him alone. For that depend upon Him. Love Him. Know Him. Study about Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fill your heart with Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fear from everything, but we don't fear Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is very clear in our own actions. Very clear in our own actions. Some of us ask Allah save. Alhamdulillah, majority is good, but some of us, their own desire is their own ilah. As Allah mentioned in Quran Kareem, is those who worship their own desires. They know about Allah anything, believe me not. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about two people, إِنَّ هَذَانِ لَا يَعْرِفَانِ مِنْ دِينِنَا شَيْئًا. These two people doesn't know nothing from our religion. Study our religion in order to know. Allah Azza wa Jal saying, and if He touch you with any good, He is able to do whatever He wants by the way He wants. عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَى أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لن ينفعوا إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك. Knows that if the whole ummah, an ummah in Arabic contain jinn and human being. Both. They get together from the first one till the last one all. to benefit you with anything, they will never ever be able to benefit you except with something already Allah write it down. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means by the permission of Allah, relate yourself to Allah. وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامِ وَجَفَّتِ الصُّحُفِ. And you must know if the whole ummah, from beginning till the end, gather themselves together in order to harm you with anything, they will never ever be able to harm you with anything except with a thing already written upon you. Already written upon you. The pen of writing of your destiny already raised up. Finish. The writing is finished. No more new writing. And whatever written is dry. This from the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ayah number 103, surah number 6, لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير. No vision can grasp Allah, but Allah grasps all visions. Whatever your eyes see, Allah knows it. Whatever you see, يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. Allah knows if you betray by your own eye. You look to something, you should not look at it. Allah knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever you hide in your chest, Allah knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, from the greatness of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah say, nobody can grasp Allah. Nobody can see Him in the dunya. But He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sees everything. And He knows everything. Whatever in your mind, and you never ever talk about it, Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, knows it. Try to know about the one who knows everything about you, and He is watching you all the time. All the times without exception. If this is in your mind, which in Arabic Arabin muraqaba. Muraqaba, that you must know that Allah is watching you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. Be with Allah, Allah will be with you. Be with Allah, Allah will be with you. In Arabic, kun ma'allah, yakun illahu ma'ak. Allah will be with you with His knowledge. Allah will be with you with His rahmah. Allah will be with you with His rizq. Allah will be with you with His protection. Allah will be with you with all of what you need. Nobody can give you nothing, and nobody can benefit you with anything except Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Latif al-Khabir, the most merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The most experienced one, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Aqman, about that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ayah number 16, surah number 31, إِنَّهَا إِن تَكُ مِثْقَالُ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ. If it is only just a weight of a grain. Grain. فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ inside a stone. Or in the heavens. Or in the earth. Allah will bring it forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is able to bring it. We know the story of the war was inside the big stone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who feed it. And we know the story of Sayyidina Sulaiman. When he tried to put one of the ant inside a yani bottle and lock it. And he asked here, because Allah taught Sayyidina Sulaiman the language of everything. Asked, how much you eat? He said, one grain, a whole year. So we want to put it in here, in it, as a, 1 year. And how much you drink? She said, one drop of water. After 1 year, he came and he looked. If she eat only half of the grain and drink only half of the water, half of the drop of water. He asked, you said to me last year that whole grain and one drop, why you eat half and half? She said, because before I depend upon Allah, I eat how much I want. But now it is in your hand. I fear that you forget me, I will be dead. For that I kept another half for the next year. In case if you remember me later. Look, subhanAllah, Allah does not forget nobody. But we are the one who forget Him. We are the one who forget Him. And we are the one who recommend it. For that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us in Quran Kareem a lot. Remember Allah Azza wa Jal. Be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not fear nobody except Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say the right and the truth. Doesn't matter what will happen. But this is if you are a mu'min. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-wahid al-ahad, the only one. لا شريك له في ألوهيته ولا في ربوبيته ولا في أسمائه وصفاته. Have no any partner in His lordship, have no partner in His worship, have no partner in His beautiful names, have no partner in His qualifications, have no partner in His kingdom, have no partner in His greatness, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is a glory, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing equal to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ Allah is only one. اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ الَّذِي يُصْمَدُ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْحَاجَاتِ The only one you need Him in all of your affairs. He's alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Him. لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ He begetteth not. Not He was begotten. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ Nothing equal to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Ala Imran, about the greatness of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ayah number 26, and this is contained the great name of Allah. This ayat, as Rasulullah s.a.w. say, the great name, Ismullah al-A'zam, the great name of Allah, in this ayat. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكُ Oh Allah, the owner of whole kingdom. Is there any owner to the whole kingdom except Him? Nothing. And we know from His kingdom little, the sun and the moon and whatever around it and two, three other planets around. But greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the great kingdom of Allah, only Him is the one who knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He give us little of it to see. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ The owner of all kingdom. You give in the kingdom to whom you will, and you take it from whom you will, and you raise up whom you want, and you put down disgrace whom you want. Allah saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala, giving and taking, raising and putting down. Giving to whom He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, taking it from Him He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ raising up, give izzat, glory, to whom you will, dignity, and you take it out from whom you will. He said, بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ In tafasir, بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ means in your hand all kinds of goodness. In tafasir, interpretation, they used to say, بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ وَالْمَعْنَى and the meaning is, and also in the all, because this is contained for us. Giving is something good. Taking for us is something not good. For that بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ and in your hand is the good, and also not in your hand whatever is not good. No. Allah mentioned only بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ in your hand, only the good, means all of this giving or taking, raising or putting down is good. Because we think that giving is good and taking out the kingdom from somebody is bad. No, maybe it is good for him to prevent him from something wrong or haram or to commit some dhulm, wrongdoing. تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُزِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ Raising up whom he will. People of ilm, people of knowledge, people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And putting down whom he will subhanahu wa ta'ala. May it is good for him. Instead of maybe Allah will give him a position, he will be tyrant. For that Allah take it from him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah by His knowledge, unlimited knowledge, do whatever He wants, by the way He wants, at the time if He wants, by the word kun, kaf and noon. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But trust Him. He is the one who makes the night to go in the day, and the day to go in the night. We know that very well. The day sometimes so long, and the day so short in summer. Opposite. In the winter, the day is so short, and the night is so long. Who do that? Allah Azza wa Jalla knows about His greatness. Nobody can do that except Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole earth now, we come to know, half of it is day and the other half is a night. When Allah talk about the day and the night in the same time, because Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, by His knowledge, that it is there, but we don't know at that time. Before we didn't know, now we come to know, very few, hundreds of years ago. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the same minute you are in. Also for the 5 daily prayer. We used to think that the day have 5 daily prayer. Like al-Fajr, al-Zuhr, al-Asr. No, with al-Fajr is 5. Because in your area Fajr, in other area Zuhr, in another area Farzar, al-Asr, same minute you are in,
Everybody of us knows that. Sometimes we finish the prayer call, your family, in some places, oh, we just finish the Zuhr. Some other people from different country, a little bit farther, we just finish the Asr. We just finish the Maghrib. We just finish the Isha in the same. For that, the 5 daily prayer in every single prayer in every place in the whole earth is greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who can do that except Him? Who can do that except Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? But know Him. Love Him. Relate yourself to Him. Depend upon Him. We depend upon the dunya. We depend upon the money. We trust the money. The dollar, reading it. In God we trust. Which God? Which God? Subhanallah. Who can do that? 5 daily prayer in every single prayer in every place in the whole earth. Any place you want. You'll find Fajr and Zuhr and Asr and Maghrib and Isha, 5 daily prayer in the same minute. But the different places. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before we didn't know that, now you know it. To know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, guidance in hand of Him. It's not in hand of anyone. In Surah Al-Kahf, مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِي وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ وَلِيًّا مُرْشِدًا. Whoever Allah guide, this is the truly guided one. And whoever misleaded, you will never find anybody to guide him. Guidance in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal alone. قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. Say, the guidance of Allah is the truly guidance. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, seek it from Him. Know about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you be with Allah, Allah will be with you. Story of Sayyidina Musa and Fir'aun. When Sayyidina Musa goes to the head of all tyrant, Fir'aun, he was claiming that he is Allah. And he have little bit fear. Natural fear happens sometime when you fear meeting a tyrant. The most arrogant one. What Allah said to Sayyidina Musa and his brother Harun, إنني معكما أسمع وأرى. I am with you. I hear everything and I know. Don't fear. لا تخافا. Don't fear. Except Allah عز وجل. Same for us. Do not fear except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. When it become tight upon سيدنا موسى and he was running from Fir'aun and Bani Israel was behind him and Fir'aun and his soldiers, all of them coming behind, and some of the followers of Sayyidina Musa say, "Inna la mudrakun." When they look behind, said, "Oh, he will catch us. Will be calamity in front of us, the sea, Red Sea, and behind us, Fir'aun and his soldier." What Sayyidina Musa said? Depend upon Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Now, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is there. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is there. For that, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala ordered him, just hit the sea. Allah make it there. The water become like a mountains, open. Not only that, if he goes, is the everybody knows the end of the split, and the end the land of the sea from down is very muddy. It can be kill all of them. It become dry road, and with the same water, safety for Sayyidina Musa is the same water who killed Fir'aun and his soldier. Subhanallah, greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greatness of Allah. Same thing, Allah make it a way of safety. Same thing, Allah make it a way of destroying Fir'aun. For that, some of the things coming, inshallah, later. Some of the things to you with the rahmah of Allah will be ni'mah. Will be favor. Will be grace. Same thing with no rahmah from Allah to you, it will be niqmah. It will be evil. It will be wrong. It will be calamity. Same. Qudrah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Greatness of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be with Him. He will make everything good for you. Everything. Doesn't matter what it is. But if you do not fear except Him. If you do not depend except upon Him. If you trust really Him. This is really you will be. Also, when he was in Musa going to the sea. And they say, oh, he's catching. He will catch us. We'll be destroyed. He said, Kalla. No. Inna ma'ya Rabbi sayahdeen. Allah is with me. He will guide me. Look to yourself in a situation like that. In a situation like that, you are in a ship and it will be destroyed. What will you remember? If you remember Allah Azza wa Jal, excellent. Alhamdulillah. Congratulations. But if you remember everything other than Allah, condolence for you. Because this is will come out to you whatever in your heart really. Money and dunya, you will mention money and dunya. Some people, when they die, shadu la ilaha illallah, shadu Muhammad Rasulullah. Some people, when they die, oh, turn on the song. Oh, I need to do this and I need to do that. Don't do this, don't do that. All of it related to the dunya, alayhi billah. Was that very important? In a very hardship like that, Sayyidina Musa said, no. In Allah is with me, He will guide me what to do. Look to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr. When both of them goes to the cave of Hira, at the time of migration. And all kuffar was over it. Sayyidina Abu Bakr said to him, Ya Rasulullah, if one of them look down, he will see us. What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? La tahzan inna Allah ma'ana. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't feel sad. La tahzan. And repeated in the Quran a lot. La tahzan. Don't feel sad. Allah is with us. Allah is the one who will protect us. Fawud amraka ila Allah. Put your all of your affairs in hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry, they will not see us. Because the vision of them in hand of who? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He wants to see them something, He will make them to see it. If He doesn't want, doesn't matter what they do. Khawla bint Tha'laba went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I was told with that inshallah. Went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she was complaining against her husband. Or not complaining, talking against her husband. In one of the corners, far from Sayyidah Aisha. Sayyidah Aisha was يعني, not that far, but يعني, with them. She said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran Kareem, beginning of Surah Al-Mujadala, قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا. Allah heard the argue of that woman about her husband. What our mother Aisha said, she said, تَبَارَكَ سَمْعُ اللَّهُ. She said, blessed is the hearing of Allah. I was near to them, I didn't hear nothing. And Allah from above seven heaven, He heard her, what she's saying to Rasulullah. She was near to them, and she couldn't hear anything. When she said that woman was saying to Rasulullah, argue about her husband. And blessed is the hearing of Allah from above seven heaven, He heard her when she told. For that Allah hear you. Allah nearer to you than the blood in your body, by His knowledge, not by Himself. Because if you say by Himself, another calamity, which it is al-hululiyyah. Hululiyyah is the one they say, the people who is a firqa and Muslim, they say that Allah is in us and I am Allah and Allah is me. Walayyazu billah. Kufr. Walayyazu billah. Also same mistake which is not intentionally. Allah is everywhere, completed by His knowledge. By Himself, what is Him? Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa. Ar-Rahman rose over al-Arsh. Yes, He is everywhere by His knowledge, by His power, by His mercy. By His Qudrat, not by Himself. Otherwise, by Himself in His bathroom, by Himself in the pig's farm, by Himself in the bad places, no. By His knowledge. For that here, blessed is the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us with Him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always be with us. And to protect us. And to save us. And to admit us to Jannah. And to save us from النار. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم. ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر. والطف بنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم. ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر. والطف بنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير. واجعلنا متبعين لا مبتدعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا متبعين لكتابك ولسنة نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم لا مبتدعين يا حي يا قيوم. وانصرنا ولا تنصر علينا. وأعنا ولا تعن علينا. وانصرنا على من بغى علينا.
اللهم انصرنا على من بغى علينا واهدنا ويسر الهدى إلينا وارحنا وفرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. And all those I ask you, by the great name of Allah and by the greatness of Allah, remember us in the best of your dua, and the angel will say to you the same. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.